The proper heir to the throne was an 8-year-old boy called Edmund, living in Ireland, the great-grandson of King Edward's second son. Henry's father was the third son, so Henry was certainly not heir to the throne. He was a big man, with a big red beard and a big army, and he was sitting right there in England on the throne, not in Ireland, not 8 years old, so Parliament decided that he was very definitely fully entitled to be King of England. Oh, yes! Edmund spent the whole of Bolingbroke's reign as a well-maintained prisoner. Henry was the first king to speak English as his native tongue. He was personable, brave, and a very capable leader in battle, but without legitimacy, he was clinging to power by his fingernails. Anyone who doubted Bolingbroke's right to be King of England could expect to be part hanged and then have their intestines pulled out before being killed. His regime became ever more repressive as he became more worried. There was an uprising in the north which he put down with real ferocity. It was said that he personally killed 30 men in battle.
And the air hung heavy with the smoke of burning flesh as the English church under this new regime began burning heretics. The usurper needed to rule by fear, but the most frightened person in England was him.
Government was taken over by his son, also called Henry, a young man who'd grown up fighting on his father's behalf. In fact, Parliament suggested that the king abdicate in his son's favour, which he refused to do. In 1413, the Grim Reaper came with a more convincing offer. He was only 45 years old.